It's that time of year again, guys, where everyone gets all jolly and shit, and your uncle's drunk on the floor again with all the fucking eggnog that he drank. But, you know, that's just how it is. And Santa comes down the chimney and brings you all these toys, and he bangs your mom. Never got why. My dad never got, knew that, really. You know, it was in the song. My mom used to play that song all the time, and Dad didn't know. But that's, but hey, he got the case for Brandacity, so. So if we're gonna be doing a 90s Christmas special, what movie should that be? Of course it's always gonna be. Do you guys hear that? Someone really pissed off and yelling. Huh. Who the fuck is this? Ringing my goddamn, banging on the door this late at night. Oh, it's Brandon. What the fuck are you doing here? I was about to get all smashed and drink eggnog and watch Home Alone and call my relatives and tell them that they fucking suck.
Dude, I have been on the internet, right? And I've realized that no one considers Care Bears Nutcracker Suite a Christmas movie. I mean, what is more caring than Care Bears on Christmas, Austin?
There's a lot of things that are way better than that fucking thing, but okay.
Name one.
Die Hard.
What?
You know what the fuck? What the fuck? People out there don't think that that's a fucking Christmas movie. You've never watched Die Hard?
No.
Oh, well, we're gonna put that little fucking baby to bed today. Fuck Home Alone. We're doing Die Hard.
Yeah, baby.
Look at me,
I'm kind
of rich.
Plaza.
This channel is reserved for emergency calls only.
Do I sound like I'm ordering a pizza?
Ah, sweet, now I can finally take my Christmas sweater off.
Oh, wow, that was a great Christmas sweater.
Thank you.
I want to take off my Christmas sweater.
Wait, what?
Yeah, my Christmas sweater, Brandon. My Christmas. Today we're going to be watching Die Hard. Brandon's never watched Die Hard, so we're going to watch it. This movie came out in 1988, starring Bruce Willis.
Hey, motherfucker.
Unbreakable, The Sixth Sense, and a couple other action films like The Expendables and other things. Also, Alec Rickman, which played Professor Snape in Harry Potter. So, and a couple other movies. It was in Dogma. I remember him being in Dogma.
Tuckhead. Takiyo building.
Teriyaki building.
teriyaki
toto. Teriyaki toto.
That guy must be loaded.
Like Tokunawa or whatever the building. Well, whatever. We're past that. And, you know, everything's pretty hunky-dory. You know, he gets off the plane. She's like, oh, you know, John McCain. John McClane. Which is the cousin John McCain.
Right.
Everyone should know that. That's a piece of trivia you should remember. Is John McCain was in this film. He's actually the guy that was the Russian with the blonde hair and the big glasses. That was actually him in all makeup. So we got this going on, and then I don't know where the Russians, these weird Russians, come in.
Another theme of the 80s.
Yes, like, totally, like, what is with that? Like, everything was about the Russians around that time. Rocky IV,
mm-hmm.
Of course, which is the best Rocky of all. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
You can't
easily.
Easily. You know, what was it? The Hunt for Red October came out around then.
Yeah.
So that's more Russian bullshit. And of course, you know, communism.
Yes.
But back to the movie.
You are done. No more table. Where are you going, pal? Next time you have a chance to kill someone, don't hesitate.
Thanks for the advice.
So, of course, we see Bruce Willis. He escaped, and he's gonna try to get the building back. That's exactly what you should do in that kind of situation. And he's a cop. That's exactly what you do.
Only if you're a cop. If you're a civilian, I wouldn't recommend that. I wouldn't recommend trying to fight terrorists in a building.
Yep. So here we actually see Bruce Willis fighting John McCain.
He's a decent family man, citizen that I just happen to have disagreements with on fund abuse, and that's what this campaign is all about.
Let it snow.
Welcome to the party, pal. Holy shit, is that Carl?
Wait, that's Carl Winslow.
Yeah, it's Carl Winslow from fucking Family Matters. You know, you want to hear a really funny story about Family Matters, okay? You ready for this? So, our buddy Gomer, actually, when he gets interns, when he hires them at his accounting firm,
yeah.
He literally tells them, be like, hey, we'll actually raise your pay if you can get us the first season of Urkel. And so, like, these people go in and try to look up Urkel.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, on Amazon, and it won't come up, like, the seasons. And they're like, what the fuck? And they don't realize that the show is called Family Matters. For you millennials, or, like, some people out there that don't know what Family Matters is, Family Matters was a TV series with this guy in it. He was the dad, and of course, Urkel kind of took the spotlight with that.
Did I do that?
But there was a lot of sitcoms. Like, the 90s and 80s were made of sitcoms. Like, Step by Step, Boys Meets World, Family Matters, Friends, Miami Vice.
Great sitcoms like that.
God, kill me. So, here's a little bit of trivia for this movie that you probably didn't know, was this movie actually is the only movie that has, like, it was very highly grossing glass budget. So the scene that we saw just there where, like, you know, all the glass, like, it's shot and everything and that abandoned, like, well, they're trying to build, like, a new office or whatever. All that is actually real glass, and they, like, spent a lot of money on it so they could get that shot. But now it's in Bruce Willis's foot.
Yeah, I bet they didn't, you know, the glass company didn't want their glass be advertised in that movie, because it broke pretty easy.
That's true. Sorry, glass company, you're all oust. Another cool trivia point is the part here that we're showing.
Well, the boys down here will be glad to hear that. You know, we got a pool going on you.
What kind of odds am I getting?
You don't want to know.
Put me down for 20. I'm good for it. Hey, pal. You got flat feet?
What the hell are you talking about, man?
Something had to get you off the street.
What's the matter? You don't think jockeying papers across a desk is a noble effort for a cop?
Yeah, that gruesome fucking part where, like, Bruce Willis is pulling the glass out of his fucking foot. They actually edited that film. So this movie was already rated R, and they were actually going to make it N-17 because they were putting in a sound effect in where it sounded like the glass was coming out of his foot.
Oh, okay.
And it was like, you know, it was like, but they decided to go not with it because if they did go with it, then the N-17 would have been rated. So kind of shitty. But hey, it's cool. Still a good movie so far.
We have left nothing to chance.
Get them back. Not mine.
Now I have a machine gun.
Now Bruce Willis is talking trash to these straight Russians. He literally just fucking took John McCain's body and put it in an elevator and, like, put a sweatshirt on and was like, I have a machine gun, ho, ho, ho.
Which would be very offensive now.
How? How is that offensive then? Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so moving on to this bullshit. Motherfuckers now. Mm-hmm. All right, so this is getting pretty entertaining.
Oh, John, what the fuck are you doing? How the fuck did you get into this shit?
I promise I will never
even think about going up in a tall building again.
Please don't let me die.
Extinguisher attached to himself like a fire hose and jumped out of a building that was exploding a little bit.
Yeah.
So pretty badass guy. Bruce Willis is fucking badass, but just remember, Bruce Willis was dead at the end of Sixth Sense. I fucking ruined it. And it, no, fuck you. Spoiler alert, fuck you. No, because you should have been watching that goddamn movie. It's been 20 goddamn years. M. Night Shyamalan's done a whole bunch of other shitty films leading up to that film. So yeah, fuck them. Sorry. Christmas.
Yeah.
And these Russians.
This gets me in that mood too.
Communism fucks me.
Oh, yes. What was it you said to me before? Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
So this is a very smart fucking idea, but this is one of the craziest ideas I've ever seen. This guy literally, like, Bruce Willis puts a fucking gun and, like, fucking gift tape wraps it on the back of his back.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And he's gonna stand off with Hans fucking Gruber. You know, just watch out, Bruce. Remember, he knows that fucking kill spell. What is it, what's that kill spell?
Avada Kedavra.
Avada Kedavra. That's what it is.
Wait, it was?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was that thing that Grumpy Bear knew.
God damn it. You are not bringing up the fucking Care Bears when we're watching Die Hard. You're gonna bring up the Care Bears more, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Ah, okay. Let's just fucking move on.
Happy trails, Hans.
So they have their showdown, but let's go back to this clip right here. See that face? That's the face of fucking terror. You know why? Because they played a fucking goddamn joke on Alan Rickman. So we actually were talking about this at the beginning, before we started watching this film, and it was, they didn't tell Alan Rickman that they were dropping him at a certain point, because usually you go like 3, 2, 1, drop,
yeah.
And they went 3, 2, and dropped him.
Yeah.
So they could get that genuine fear scare of like him dying, like, or feel like he's falling. So it was a good piece of cinema. Probably gave Alan Rickman a heart attack, but it's okay. He's Professor Snape.
But not until like 20 years later.
Too soon. Too goddamn soon. Oh, man. So let's talk about the film a little bit. So, Brandon, what'd you think of Die Hard?
I mean, it was no Care Bear Nutcracker Suite, but it was pretty decent, I say.
Did you hear that? This is what this country's gone to. You're the reason why Brandon likes the fucking Care Bears thing. Die Hard is a goddamn Christmas film. I don't care if fucking Bruce Willis said that it's not. It's a fucking Christmas film. Look at this. This is a goddamn American treasure. And you're gonna play it during Christmas. You know what? Your mom puts in fucking Elf. Slap that bitch in the face. Put fucking Die Hard in. Your goddamn mom puts Christmas Story in. Fuck Ralphie. Put fucking Die Hard in. Your mom fucking puts in A Wonderful Life. Fuck that old motherfucker. Put Die Hard in.
They really should replace the tower with a Christmas tree if they're wanting to go for a Christmas special.
Get the fuck out of my house, Brandon! Get the fuck out! Now! Get the fuck out of my- Take your baby oil with you. Christmas!
Sooner or later, Austin forgave Brandon because Brandon brought him beer.
God bless you, sir!
But Austin knew that the best gift is giving. He bought Brandon baby oil that Christmas day. Merry Christmas from everyone here at Classy Nerd Talk. Make sure that you like, share, and subscribe. And as always, stay classy.